Ken Priddy here with the Ghost Center. I'd like to spend a few minutes speaking with you about the church life cycle. Now, what you see on our board here is a bell curve, just a standard bell curve that's often used to depict life cycle. And I want to identify three primary stages of life cycle. First, there is incline, and then recline. And on the back side, we have decline. Now, there's much that could be said about these three primary stages, but I really want to focus on one particular aspect today. And that has to do with ministry capacity. Ministry capacity speaks to the amount of ministry that a church provides and the quality in which that ministry is provided. So there is a quantitative element, how much, and a qualitative element, how well. How much ministry does this church provide over certain periods of time? How well do we do it? Well, the inclining church is a church that is on the upside of the life cycle. It's growing, it's expanding, and part of that expansion is to expand its ministry capacity. Over time, it's doing more and more ministry, and it's doing that ministry better and better. So there is a quantitative increase and a qualitative increase to ministry capacity when the church is inclining. Now, when we get to recline, what we see is that the ministry capacity of the church levels off. Another word for recline might be the word plateau. George Barna, who's a church analyst, has written that churches in plateau often don't realize they're in crisis. I think that's a very important concept, because many churches that are in plateau, rather than sensing that they're in crisis, their self-perception is they have actually arrived. They've reached the plateau. Things have stabilized. They're very predictable. They're manageable. There are systems in place. It's comfortable. Very often, early decline is also financially very stable. So churches in recline don't have a sense of being in crisis. They have a sense of being solid, stable, comfortable, and they like being where they are. However, the ministry capacity of a church in recline typically has leveled off. The church is doing the same kinds of ministries at the same level of quality over and over and over again. In fact, there's sort of a hidden sense of wishing that time would freeze so that every Sunday would be just like last Sunday. Every 7 days we would repeat this because we're doing so well. We're so predictable. We're so stable. However, if we're not expanding our ministry capacity, we are headed for the backside of the life cycle. Now, when we get to the backside of the life cycle, we begin to descend into decline. Now, a church in decline is experiencing a decrease in its ministry capacity. Over time, the church is doing less and less ministry, and the quality of that ministry is more and more compromised. Back in the 90s, I was called to pastor a church that had declined down to 13 members. Steep decline. And when I arrived there, I found that there was almost no ministry taking place. The capacity of that church to minister had been completely reduced down to simply these 13 people more or less taking care of each other. We don't want to find ourselves in that spot. Decline, of course, is not where we want to be, and we are going to try to reverse that trend. Now, that leads me to a principle I want to share with you. And the principle is this. The life cycle is a one-way street. It only moves from left to right. Now, the reason that's important is because very often as I find churches on the declining side of the life cycle, their hope is to back up. They're wishing they could go back to a time, some previous time in the life of the church, when things were going on much better than they are now. So there's a desire to recreate what we would now call recline. Well, the problem with that is, first of all, it can't be done. Time only moves in one direction. Another thing is this. If you arrive at recline from the backside of the life cycle, your version of recline is going to be a very anemic version. What makes recline so preferable in the present only happens if we arrived at recline from the inclining side of the life cycle, because there's a lot of energy, a lot of momentum that incline brings to recline. Well, if you're shooting from recline out of decline, you don't have that momentum. So your version of recline is a very weak version. So what exactly do you do? How do you deal with the issue of life cycle when you find yourself on the backside? Well, let's say that a given church is at this spot on the back of the life cycle. We're not going to back up. What we're going to do is cut that life cycle off and end it, and we are going to launch a new season of incline. And now that we understand more of the dynamics of the life cycle, we're not going to allow the new life cycle to lapse into recline and decline. But by making periodic adjustments, we can launch another season and another season. So the goal is not to create a never-ending season of incline, but rather to stack one season of incline on top of another, on top of another. That is how you manage the life cycle in strategic ways to keep ministry fresh, keep ministry expanding, and keep growing your ministry capacity. Now, we do all of this in an effort to find who's missing and bring them home.